In this brief demonstration of the Linktropy WAN emulator, we'll see how to easily evaluate the performance of network applications over various wide area networks. First, we'll install the Linktropy WAN emulator. We'll need to put it between the devices and the networks that we want to appear to be on opposite ends of the WAN. For this example, we'll connect the LAN A Ethernet port to the test network that represents our Los Angeles office, and we'll connect the LAN B port to the network that represents the New York office. The Linktropy WAN emulator can act as a bridge or as a router between these two segments. With the Linktropy device physically installed, we're ready to configure it. All we need for this is a standard web browser, so we can work from whatever desktop is most convenient. Here we see that browser interface, and it's open to the tab where we'll find everything we need to describe our WAN conditions. To configure an emulated link, we'll simply set the bandwidth, delay, loss, and background traffic characteristics of that link. For example, let's say it's a T3 line that we have between our Los Angeles and New York offices. Well, a T3 line is 45 megabits per second in each direction, and the distance between these two cities causes a constant delay of about 40 milliseconds in each direction. Since this is a dedicated private line, there's generally no loss, so we'll leave the packet loss rate and bit error rate at zero. We'll also assume that we're not sharing the link with any other network traffic. Now we apply the changes we've made, and we're ready to find out how our applications will perform. As an easy-to-see example, we'll test a simple file transfer application. We'll use it to download a file from a server that's across the WAN. First, we'll start the transfer, and then we'll open the Linktropy monitor window. The Linktropy monitor window shows us in real time what's happening on the emulated link. A quick glance at the top graph shows us that the file transfer is consuming about 7 megabits per second in the LAN A to LAN B direction. More detailed counters for each direction across the WAN are updated every second. If we wanted to analyze these second-by-second statistics later, we could download the last 24 hours of data in CSV format. Returning to the file transfer, we can see it reports a transfer rate of a little over 800 kilobytes per second, which is about what we expected from what we saw on the monitor page. We could test any other application just as easily as this file transfer. For instance, we could run a voice over IP call across the emulated WAN and listen to the resulting quality. Or we could stream a video across and watch how the quality changes as the conditions change. A fixed T3 line is pretty simple, so let's take a quick look at another configuration, like for a VPN to a remote office that's on a DSL line. This connection would be a bit slower, possibly asymmetric, would have a variable delay, which will make the same in both directions, and maybe would have a little loss in the upstream direction. We just apply these changes to the emulation, and they immediately take effect. Now we can determine such things as how the jitter caused by the variable delay affects our voice calls. If we want to see how our call quality changes when there are a bunch of other calls in progress, we can dial up the background traffic rate and evaluate that effect. Less common emulation conditions are kept out of the way in the advanced parameters section, but if you need to see the effect of unusual conditions like packet reordering or duplication, it's just as easy to add and apply these as any of the others. Once we've completed our testing, we can analyze the data that we've collected. We'll be able to make informed decisions, whether about network design, application tuning, or product purchasing. For more information on the Linktropy product, please see our website at www.apposite-tech.com or call us toll-free at 866-WAN-SIM-8.